patient comes with the eruption in the elbow. But what is interesting here in the eruption, that it is, many things are interesting, that at the age of 50, patient has no other issues, healthy, except for infectious diseases in the childhood. Patient has had no pathology. Very interesting. Second, you see that the problem, I say, what does it bother you? Yes, not much. So it does not bother much. You think the doctor is more bothered than I am. Does not bother him much. So for him, the attitude is, if it goes, it is good. If it doesn't, it is okay. Is he desperate? No. This is the attitude. Then, so we have two things here. We have the location, elbow, eruption with some itching. And secondly, you have this attitude, this kind of relatively healthy guy who says, well, if it goes, it's okay, good. If not, okay. So with this thing, we go into his understanding of his mind state. And he says that the main thing for him was that he was influenced by a very strong personality of his uncle, isn't it? Father's uncle, na? Father's uncle. Not his uncle, father's uncle. This is a very strong influence on his mind. And what is the main story of this father's uncle? That the father's uncle had very strong principles. And what are those principles? Principle is basically, what do you think? What are the main principles of the father's uncle, according to him? Which is? Bend upon pressure, okay. What, that is one, but what is a more important thing? To think of nation, not of yourself. Not your career, but the nation. This is the, isn't it the main story? This is very important. And then, so he was a communist. What does mean a communist? No, that is not the principle of communism. What's the real principle of communism? Equal is democracy. Communism means nothing belongs to you. What is the principle of communism? Nothing belongs to you. Everything belongs to community. So in real, very strict communist countries, which hardly exist nowadays, the idea was nothing of yours. I think they had a principle. From each according to his ability, to each according to his need. This was the principle. So you get what you need and you give what you can. So nothing, your own individual ambition is not allowed. You can't amass wealth You can't do, you know, you don't have anything of yourself. It's a community living. In Israel, they have communities like that, which is known as kibbutz. Again, the same principle. It's a community living. All of you contribute. So the nation becomes a kind of bigger family. Nothing for yourself. So anyway, this any doesn't matter. And what is the second thing about the uncle? It's about being bullied, isn't it? So his uncle said, he told his uncle, father's uncle, see, I'm getting bullied. And the uncle says, don't let him bully you. So what is bully? So when a person of position or strength takes advantage of somebody less stronger or less privileged. This is the main story. You will see this coming up again and again in the case. Isn't it so? So what are the two stories? Am I doing for myself or am I doing for nation or community? Secondly, am I allowing the kind of oppression or you can say bullying or taking advantage of somebody less than me? Or am I, what's the opposite? Elevating them. Koi garib mila, if I found a poor guy, am I going to squeeze him or am I going to lift him? These are the two sides. So, and then he gives many examples, like in a corporate situation. You can oppress the other person, take advantage, make him do your personal work because his pay is dependent on you. Or you can create a situation where it's not one person, but the entire team that has an identity. So it's the same story with the cricket, isn't it? In cricket, either you can say, I want to make a name for myself, so I will score runs, even if the team doesn't win. Or you can say, I am going to play for the team. Do you see the same story over and over again? Yes, no? And then you see that what are his stress factors, where his own people, his grandmother, mother, father, he's very, very very concerned about them. And in fact, after his grandmother died, his elbow started improving. So what is this showing? It's showing the level. The level in the case is psychosomatic. That means the mind affects the body. This is level 3. That is the reason why he doesn't have prominent dreams. Because level 3, there are no dreams. Level 4, there are dreams. So we have the symptom, eruptions on the elbows, eruptions, itching. We have the miasm, which is ringworm. That means if it is there, it is okay, but if it goes, it is good. Ringworm miasm, level 3. And with the main two themes, the themes are that people on position take advantage, they bully them. And second theme, am I going to work for myself or for the nation or for the community? And another theme of the remedy is very concerned about his loved ones, about his family. And then he talks about people who make so much money by killing the, they don't care, they are so inhuman that they allow people to die so that they can make the money. They're so bad, so self-centered. The opposite is what he is going to do. He is going to take his money and do something for the village. Exactly the opposite. Bring power and water and whatever it may be. These are the two sides, no? Two sides of what? Two sides of a human being. They are the two sides, strong sides of a human being. On one side, human being want for me. And on the other side, he says, no, I have to also do for the community. Two sides. We call, like, on the one side, can say, selfish, on the side, selfless. On the one side, God, another side, devil. Who has created God and devil? Human being. Normally, dogs do not have this conflict. Or ducks. Am I laying the egg for myself? Or am I laying the egg for somebody else? They don't have this conflict. They are pure. Our mind is messed up. And what is the story, history of man all the time? Only one common history in man. What is that? Oppression. Anywhere you see, main word of human being is exploitation. The story of man is exploitation of man by man. Anywhere they will go and colonize, they will go and make slaves, then there will be ooch neech, then there will be social classes, caste system, king system, invader system, colonization system, capitalism system. Everywhere it is the story of exploitation of man by man. This is human history. And on the other hand, some few sparks of extraordinary benevolence, isn't it? We take examples like Jesus Christ or Gandhi or Mother Teresa, or they are also human. They represent the exact opposite side. So the two sides of man, very strong. So in that sense, we can think of lac humanum because it is a also ringworm miasm. And then how do we know that it's a remedy is correct? So you look at the rubrics, which are as follows. One theme is helplessness. Another is anxiety for loved ones. Third is the domination of others aggravate. Fourth is cannot support injustice. Then you see unfeeling, hard-hearted, unsympathetic, and also help others want to. So these are the two sides that we are able to see in him. So this he attributes to other people. We could even remove them and put them somewhere else into another group. Indifference to suffering, unfeeling, hard-hearted. This is inhuman, unsympathetic, unscrupulous. So, when we see the good side, so you see again, lac humanum. Wants to help others, cannot tolerate injustice or domination, love for his family, helplessness. You see lac humanum. And then you see the indifference also is lac humanum. Hard-hearted, the two sides, human and inhuman. And then comes his story with the eruptions. Eruptions, elbows and itching of the elbows. Again you see in it lac humanum. which is his chief complaint. And finally, you have an interesting discussion that we had, isn't it, with him? And the discussion was about his interest in philosophy and spirituality. And the main thing is two sides. Either you are here or you cross over to the other side. What is this side and that side? What is the one side? What is the other side? Material and the other? Spiritual, yeah. So this is the conflict inside between higher consciousness and worldly existence. Am I the material being or am I the spiritual being? If you are material being, you will become egoistic, selfish, amassing wealth, power, position. But if you become a spiritual being, you lose sense of self and you become benevolent, you become spiritual. So all these so-called spiritual people, like Jesus or Mother Teresa, whatever you can, whatever name you can think of, usually they won't have anything for themselves, isn't it? Because they feel or they have an experience of not being material. They feel one with higher consciousness. So in that sense, these two sides of what he's talking about, I am this side or that side. This is where he wants to marry science and religion. Try to bring something common. So we can see how his whole story is a story of lac humanum. We already know the potency, which is 200. It's not a progressive disease. In fact, it's getting better. So no reason to repeat. Just 4 doses of lac humanum and repeat as and when needed, whenever there is a recurrence, if at all. He should do very, very good on this remedy. Good. Any questions? Oh.
Hello. Sir, I fully agree with your view on this full case, you know, regarding this me versus you fighting for dominance, you know, protecting people, you know, in a lesser position and coming to lac humanum. I was thinking in a little different manner. I felt that this, you know, person has extreme sense of duty and responsibility, you know, and beyond the kind of sixth row responsibility, you know, and you know, this kind of thinking that you should do for the nation at a larger scale, a duty at a very large scale, and fighting for fighting against injustice, freedom fighters, fighting against bullying, you know. I thought of Lanthanide series, and this interest of his in spirituality, merging science and spirituality, finding the higher purpose, higher meaning of life, what's on the other side. That also, of course, I thought in that way. And this dream which he had in his childhood, you know, that kind of a fan spinning. I was just wondering as to what it could look like, you know. It, you know, on the macroscopic level, it could look like as if something is revolving, maybe a sun, and something is revolving, and on a microscopic level, it looks like an atom with something revolving, an electron revolving around it. And he said it's a very large room. So, and probably he told some words like, do you play video games, one level to another level, you got to detach. So maybe your, you know, lanthanides are radioactive in nature, and they like to give away, you know, something like, you know, very spiritual people or big leaders, you know, just want to give away, not for themselves, but for the larger purpose of the society of the humankind. So there it merges with lac humanum, that yes, they have, you know, those things. And somewhere I read that, you know, substance called neomidinum, some cases that these people are, you know, they have a lot of things for liberation movement, fighting for their rights.
Very good.
Yeah, that's how very I thought good. That.
And I really appreciate
and
that.
And the sulfur part, you know, so you can think about neomidinum sulfur. It's a very strong magnet. This man has a very strong personality.
Okay.
So, a strong magnet, strong personality. You can think.
Very good. I really appreciate that you think like that.
If you go to see the entire case, there has not been much of a psychosomatic aspect apart from the skin ailment that has been developed.
Right.
And the manner in which it has got better is also having a direct correlation between the conflict area of the family and
right.
the mother, and the way it is getting better now.
Mm.
Barring this, whatever conflict or whatever issues, I would say, I don't want to even look at it as a conflict, the issues that he has talked about in terms of bullying, which was he referred to and clearly mentioned that they were in the childhood. And some present-day bullying, he has cited some examples of what bullying means. But how much they are actually bothering him, causing a psychosomatic disturbances, or any action of that sort of a conflict leading to any kind of a result in a pathological way or any disturbing way, which is not very evident in the case right now. He has talked about concepts of communism. He has talked about concepts of bullying in the society and sufferings of poor and how the rich people. All those things, his thoughts, how these thoughts are actually converting into a pathological thinking or from point of view of chronic miasmatic development of a mental state. And at the same, chronic miasmatic development at a physical state in terms of a psychosomatic impact of this kind of a conflicting thinking is not very evident in the case. Besides that, he is too much attached to his family, and as the suffering of his mother has reduced because of the now grandmother expired, or that has given him some relief that yes, now mother is going to be not that stressful, which is showing the result also. So is it good approach to still wait and see whether it is a self-resolving thing and not give any remedy and wait and see how eczema behaves?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's just a doubt.
Okay. Well, one can always wait. There's no harm at all in waiting in a person who is getting better. this is for sure. Right? Yes, we can wait and watch. But in my understanding, it is not going to self-resolve. The reason is that while if the exciting factor is getting less, the lesion may also get less. But the very fact that he has had a lesion shows that there is a state within him. And that state is not going to self-resolve. So given either it may not resolve fully, or given some other exciting factor tomorrow, it's going to shoot up again. It's just simple logic. Waiting is no problem at all. But I wouldn't wait if it was my case, because I believe that we have to treat the state in any case. So when we examine what is the state of the person, we need to identify the individualizing symptoms. As far as the elbow is concerned, we don't have too much. Eczema and itching is not very uncommon. So we have to look for the uncommon somewhere else. He doesn't have any other symptoms. So we have to look in the mind state. And we have to ask, what is it in this person that makes him an individual? What is it apart from everybody else that we have seen so far? What's distinguishing in him? What are his areas of sensitivity? And we have identified those areas very clearly. One is concern for his family, which is very, very strong, and that aggravates his problem. The second is very much concern about exploitation. It really affects him a lot to see that this politician has made 37,000 crores of rupees at the cost of the death of hundreds of farmers over 15 years. How can somebody be so inhuman? This is something that distresses him. And on the other hand, you see his great desire to help those people at the cost of his own wealth or his own efforts. He's not a very rich guy, but whatever he's going to make, he's going to devote to doing something for the community. So these are the sensitive areas that show him as an individual apart from anyone else. Very rarely you will come across such an individual. He's a rarity. A human being is a rarity among humans. This is what we understand. This is what we can understand. So, it's a pleasure to see that this thing is there. And in his mind, clearly the world is divided into two. One side is his father's uncle. On the other side is this corrupt politician. This is where the world stands divided in his own mind. And the thing he's interested in also is, am I living for my ego or for something higher than that? So this is his individuality. And that's manifesting in pathology, in any way, right? So I believe that we should treat him. Yes. And as to answer your, I don't know if you had a question or a comment. Sometimes I'm not sure with you.
I was just sharing my.
If you are just sharing, then I don't have to say anything about it.
Well,
the idea is that when you talk about fifth row or sixth row of the periodic table, right? So the intensity, the depth of the pathology, the depth of the miasm is far, far higher. For example, in lanthanide, Scholten writes about mostly autoimmune disorders, right? So we are talking about really advanced pathology. And the attitude of such a patient in a very, like, fifth row, sixth row, things like that, strong duty, responsibility, the attitude is one of great depth and desperation, which you never saw in this case. For example, I asked him, do you feel guilty about your mother and father? No, not guilt. So it's just a feeling of anxiety for them and wanting to do something. Similarly, he's not taken the nation on his shoulder. He's decided to take one village or two villages. He's not here to start a revolution or capture power at the center. So you have to understand where is the depth of the case. That depth depicts two things. One, the miasm, and secondly, the row of the periodic table or where the remedy lies, you know. So easy to say the miasm. Miasm showing that his depth, even with his problem, you know, there's nothing desperate there. So when there is a person of a certain depth, a certain desperation, a certain syphilitic miasm, a certain tubercular leprous miasm, which lanthanides or other would go into a much deeper miasm, you must see that depth reflected in every area of the case, in the chief complaint, in the, attitude towards people. I said, do you get angry? You get very anxious. Everything is mild to moderate, lukewarm. In a lanthanide or aurum or plumbum or such sixth row, you will see desperation. In the pathology also you will see. In the chief complaint you will see. Doctor, if this doesn't heal, I will die. That kind of pathology you will get. So you've got to match. This is the what I can share with you. You've got to match the depth of the remedy, with the depth of what you see in the patient at all levels, whether it is a chief complaint level, a dream level, whatever level. Even in the dream, mild. And then after that, I like your theorizing. Very good. That it is revolving, maybe it is the sun, maybe it is the atom. But I would caution also. Theorizing, I am a little bit cautious with it. You can do it, I don't mind. But again, when you have definite data, you see the conflict, you see whatever you said you agree with. When you see something with that clarity, which matches the depth, the miasm of the case, which matches the symptoms of the case, then you go with that. Only when you have nothing to do, you theorize. You have no substance at all. But usually you won't, in most cases you will get, and anything that you take, this is what I understood. You should be quite firm, sure, solid. It should be clear in the, what you see in the patient, in the remedy, it should be like that. Whack. Then you can be more confident. Okay.
In this patient, sir, I felt, why do we need to give a remedy? Because this is a very good state to be in. In fact, meaning we need more people give. We don't want to dilute his state.
Yeah. Imagine Mahatma Gandhi, if he had come to me as a patient. Pura freedom movement is satyanash ho jata. He would say, British, they are very nice people. What's the problem? I'm happy. Never angry. Steffi Segria dene ka usko 1M. Pura independence movement will be finished. Maybe. I'm not sure. Something like that.
Normal and healthy.
No, it's not healthy. Very good. Your question is good, but it's not healthy. See, human, lack humanum is a state of human being. Normally, every human should have a human state. Yes or no? So we should all experience this division between, am I doing it for myself or am I doing it for others, or am I selfish, am I self-centered? I'm sure this question must have crossed all your mind. I hope so, at some point. Otherwise, only for me. No question in my mind. One of the symptoms of lack humanum in the proving, I had done proving of lack humanum 3 times in big groups. One of the symptoms is to embarrass to eat in the presence of others. Suppose aap khana kha rahe ho, you are eating. Somebody is there. You feel or not? What do you say? Either you have to share it, or you should feel guilty, at least. I am eating, he is not getting. Yes or no? That is why the beggars know very well when to beg. When you are enjoying, when you are eating, when you come out of a restaurant, that's the best place, no? Because you feel, oh, I have done and I have not given him. Understand these very nice things about lack humanum. Another symptom of lack humanum is the word cousins. In proving is very strong, the word came very, very strong. Dreams of cousins, things of cousins, anxiety for cousins. So I tried to understand, what does the word cousins mean? Because I did the proving, right? So I had to understand it. And then I understood by asking the prover, what does a cousin mean for you? So what I understood from the prover was, a cousin is somebody that you are not duty bound to help. But if you help, you feel good. Just you imagine, your own family, father, mother, brother, sister, children, wife. If something is going wrong with them, you have no choice but to help. Otherwise, you are a criminal. Yes or no? But suppose your first cousin, second cousin, they have some health issue, some this problem, that problem. Now, you could ignore it without feeling too much pang of conscience. But if you do something for them, what does it mean? You are a good person. It's like distant relatives ki bhi khyal rakhta ho. So in that sense, all human beings are your cousins, is it not? If you extend it a little bit more. They are not immediate family, but they are all cousins. What politicians say when they give a speech, bhaiyo aur behno, na? And then what they do is another story. But they always say, bhaiyo aur behno. My brothers and sisters. So cousins. So in that sense, so this is how we understood little things. My.
Little bit extension on what she is trying to say, because somewhere what I am trying to also say is also matching what she is expressing. See, when we are talking about human tendencies or human nature and desire to help somebody, whether it is a relative or not relative, and feeling pain for somebody or its injustice or things like these are all natural human tendencies and natural human nature common amongst all humans.
Right.
But which is the line which will draw between normality and abnormality?
Yeah.
And that where do we understand that this human tendency is really not human?
Oh, very good idea. There, I will explain you. This was also a dilemma for me, because when I did a proving of lac humanum, I thought, what is it going to give us? We are all human. What is going to change? But actually the fact is that even though we are all human, we are all in different states of being. So this kind of case is very rare. You will very rarely find. I find 1 out of 10,000 patients like that. So it was a real pleasure to take his case. And the reason is that what is disease? Basically, disease is a point of stuckness. A point of stuckness. That means you are stuck in a particular perception. You are stuck in a particular sensitivity. That is disease. You are sensitive to something very specific. Everything looks exactly like that. You are wearing colored glasses, and that's all you can see. So if that colored glass is the sensitivity to exploitation, sensitivity to bullying, sensitivity to people taking advantage of people lower than them, sensitivity to inhumanity and corruption, and on the other hand, the desire, constant desire to do something, help your family, help the country, help the nation, at the cost of yourself. If this is your whole perception in life, that is disease. So you can be stuck in a human state. So even though for most of us, it's there in the background, but we are not stuck in it. This is not what we deal with in our everyday life. So when I'm giving a lecture, this is not my conflict. Am I giving a lecture for myself or for you? There's no such thought in my head. I know it's for me.
Clear.
It's clear. So, in a lac humanum person, in every stage of his life, this will be his dilemma. Am I doing this for them or for me? Of this, are they doing? Are they exploiting? Are they doing this? Should I help? Constantly. That makes it a state to be treated. Yeah. So even though we are lac humanum, all of us, we are not stuck in it all the time.
And I want to get it treated, otherwise I will get stuck.
Ah?
I want to get him treated, otherwise I will get stressed. And seeing me stressed, my patient gets stressed.
Oh, yeah. My God. Okay. What is health? Health is non-stuckness. Isn't it easy? It's the exact opposite. If disease is to be stuck, health means to be not stuck. To be where you are, how you are, what is needed, and be that way. To swim when you are in the water and fly when you are in the sky. This is health. No? To live in a specific perception and reaction is disease. To be according to what you have to be where you are, this is health. No? Yes, no? But health is ideal. Hahnemann said, no, health is, what did he say? The highest ideal cure is rapid, gentle, and permanent rest. Means even he couldn't reach there. So it's towards this state. It's to go towards the state of freedom from stuckness. That's what he wrote, no, in aphorism 9. What is it? In 9. In the healthy condition of man, the spirit-like dynamism that animates this material being with regard sensations and functions rules with unbounded sway and retains all the parts of the organism in a harmonious vital operation so that the indwelling reason-gifted spirit can freely employ this living healthy instrument for the higher purposes of existence. He copied it from me, but it's okay. Lack maternum. Maternum se hi to normally wo nikalta hai na, lack. I don't know, koi country mein, maybe the paternum bhi ho sakta hai. Very good. Hey, isme lack humanum. You can read. Huh? Provings. Very wonderful proving, wonderful. If you read that proving really in depth, you will understand yourself. That proving changed my life. Because I understood myself. Because somewhere in the background, it's always there. No? You think also, when you read, there's a dream, for example, that she was naked and she was trying to cover herself. As a dream hai. बहुत अच्छा ड्रीम लंबा ड्रीम है कैसे डिस्क्राइब किया है देन यू थिंक अरे यस ह्यूमन इज द ओनली वन हु वेयर्स क्लोथ्स
यस
आपने सोचा है कभी व्हाई
वल्नरेबल
वो पढ़ो ना प्रूविंग में सब सीक्रेट्स दिए हैं व्हाई ही वेयर्स क्लोथ्स सब दिया है उसके अंदर व्हाई ह्यूमन इज द ओनली वन हु वेयर्स क्लोथ्स Think about it. बहुत सोचने लायक है. Because he divides. There's a division, no? In animal, there's no division. Everything is one. Mm. But in human being, it's divided. Everything is divided. This you have to cover, this you can uncover. है कि नहीं? And what is it that you have to cover and why? Aise sochna padta hai. Another important dream that is written there is the dream of stool. And he gets usko stool lag jata hai aur ekdam aisa bolta hai. Disgust. Then you think, human being is the only one that is disgusted by stool.